project here was came about by virtue of a group of people in Columbus, Georgia, that wanted to improve navigation up to Columbus from Apalachicola. And it was headed up by a fellow by the name of Jim Woodruff. And they went to Congress and to get the dam authorized, and it was approved by Congress in the Rivers and Harbors Act of 1946. And that act said that there would be a series of dams on the river system for navigation and hydropower production. There had to be a lot of surveying, mapping of private property, determining ownerships, and acquiring the property that the Corps needed to buy the land for the project. And all the improvements within the area, such as cemeteries and things like that, had to be identified and moved. The people, adjacent landowners, had to be paid for their land and improvements. Timber had to be cut. It was either left for the adjacent landowner to dispose of, or the Corps would pay the landowner for it and have it removed from the lake area. Eufaula has really seen a lot of visitation as a result of the lake, and in a planning committee that they had a few years ago, the committee recognized that the lake was the number one asset for the city of Eufaula, which I think is certainly true.
Visitation is, the last 5 years, it's been approximately $4 million per year. And it's, this year has started off very good. We've got a lot of campers right now, and looks like we're gonna have a really busy summer.
Well, it's the navigation of the channel, when locking boats from the upper level of the lake to the lower level of the Chattahoochee River down. We don't have the barge traffic anymore because down at our Blunttown, they don't have enough water down there, so we don't have barge traffic anymore. So mostly now it's just the Camel over here, or the Irwin now in the Coast Guard. If you're coming in, if there's water, like if you're coming in now, like we got the water now, we can take you on through, but if you're coming in, we don't have the water, we have to raise it up to where you are and then let you back down. So it takes 12 to 15 minutes to bring it up to get you, 12 to 15 minutes to drop it back down. Because we bring in 24 million gallons of water through, so it takes about 15 minutes to put you through there. You'd be surprised what we get up here. You have some of them partying, some of them different background and thing, and some people haven't seen it before, and they just be all ecstatic about it and everything. It's just good to see somebody see something like this here, you know, and they haven't seen it before. So it gets pretty interesting up here sometimes. If you can ride it through, you can bring it through here. We have to lock it through. And an inner tube, they have to get permission, but more than likely let them through, you know.
I think probably the main work got started in the early 50s, and the lake started filling probably, I think, in the early 60s, maybe late 50s. I don't remember exactly the date, but the lake was brought up in stages. By that I mean they would raise the lake to a certain level, and then they would go out and top trees in the lake, and then bring it up a few more feet and top trees in other areas. And of course, the navigation channel had to be built at that time, because the navigation channel did not follow exactly the old river system, where the river had bends and cutoffs and things like that. They would straighten those out to shorten the navigation channel. So all of that had to be done as the lake was brought up. It probably took a year to reach full empowerment.
My responsibilities are all the electrical components, operation, control of hydro units and floodgates, and we also do the maintenance on the navigational locks. We measure our water flow in cubic feet per second, and the on average, a unit loaded at 40 megawatts. They're rated at 42 megawatts since we've had our rehab. They used to be 38 and a half megawatts, now they're 42. And it's about 6,000 cubic feet per second per unit when you're at full load with all four units. Most of our generation is done during peak demand hours, and at certain times of the year you'll have a single schedule per day. We come up and generate for a certain amount of hours, and sometimes it'll go to a split schedule and we'll generate twice a day. But if we have a lot of inflows into our reservoir, we can run 24/7 to discharge water. It's one big science project that works. It's fun. It is. It's enjoyable.